Bet. It's gonna be better, I think, by the time we get to, say, Friday. We can really dust our hands of this, but in between, we still got tomorrow. and you're not entirely done with it tomorrow. I think tomorrow overall is maybe better, but it's not perfect, okay? We still have some possibilities of severe weather tomorrow. And right now, well, look at that picture. You can't see too much of anything because there's some fog in the area, 57 degrees. Take a peek at what your visibilities will be like in the morning. Let's say you're hitting the road at about 7 a.m. Look, biggest number you're going to see, 2.8 miles worth of visibility in the city, but 0.1 for Monticello, almost down to nothing. 0.7 for Sparta, 1.8 Danbury, 1.2 for Brick. The type of visibility that could slow you down in the morning. So give yourself right now, make a little mental note, need a little extra time in the morning. High temp today was 70. Well, you should be 74, but it was just a rough day with the storms that kicked in. Look at these rainfall amounts that we had, 2 inches around Trenton. And I'll tell you what it's not picking up on is this red color that you see right there. Wherever you see the little flashes of red, that's 3 to 4 inches of rain. So we got a lot of rain out of this system. It's now pushed offshore. I don't see any rain falling for the overnight hours. Again, there was that one lone tornado report, not confirmed, but a report just to the west of the New Jersey border. We're watching this system right now, and it's a tornado maker, if you will, in Tornado Alley. It's going to be dying down. So for tomorrow, Tornado Alley gets a break. But that energy's got to go somewhere, and some of it will come to our area. I do think we're going to see some rain tomorrow. Now, is it on the severe side? It's a lower risk, maybe a 10 to 20% risk for tomorrow. But, I mean, it's out there. So here we go through the overnight hours. You're doing okay tomorrow. Maybe even some breaks in the clouds, see a little bit of sun here or there. But by 4 o'clock in the afternoon, now you're hinting at some of that moisture and some of those heavier downpours possibly coming into the area. Not everybody getting it at 4 p.m., but it's out there. Then here we go at 6 p.m., making its push through the metro areas, right through the city. And then you get to about, say, 11 p.m. It's basically offshore, but more is still onshore versus what we had tonight. Okay, here we are now. It's all gone. Maybe a little bit lingers at this hour tomorrow night, and then it truly gets out of here. Now you're looking at a good-looking Friday and a good-looking Saturday as well. But, you know, boy, all this tornadic activity that we've had around here, is this our new norm? I mean, is this something we have to get used to 2 days in a row with tornado warnings? And we are not accustomed for it here. I mean, in the Midwest, when the alarms go off, even the elementary school kids, they know what to do. Well, if you're stuck outside, let's say you're not in a car, you're walking around, you find a ditch or some sort of a depression to lie down in, make yourself as low a target as possible, lie flat on the ground. If you are in a car, well, you keep it running. You park it, but you keep it running because that way the airbags can be deployed if something hits the car and it can protect you. All right. Looking across the board, we told you a nice Friday at 78, a nice Saturday at 79. Sunday comes with a rain chance at 77, but it's not like the systems that we're dealing with today and that we had yesterday. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of next week look very nice with temperatures in the lower and mid-70s.
We need a break.
Yeah, we'll get it for sure by Friday.
All right. Thanks, Lonnie.